my sisters and brothers have been tested positive. So my sister, one of the sisters I have, she died. And before she died, she was very okay. When she went to the hospital to be tested, they found out that she was HIV positive. Telling her that she's HIV positive, she was heartbroken. And when she went back home, she wasn't happy anymore. So she even, she didn't work even. She left the work. She was discouraged. Everywhere she could go, she was feeling bad. She could think about only death. Because when she went to hospital, the only thing they could tell her that she had to prepare for death. She had to take swallow tablets, to swallow ARVs and other tablets until she dies. Because she was not given any courage that she can be well or anything can change. But all she could think of about was death. So she left the work, she didn't even do anything. She grew thin because of too much thoughts. And then suddenly, she lost her senses. She went to the hospital, they treated her, they gave her, they put her on oxygen until she died. And I have another sister, she was also tested positive. After being tested positive, for her, she had the courage in her that she can be well, she can be well. But later on, because of the counseling which was given, and doctors could tell her that you'll be fine, but you have to take drugs till you die. You have to take medicine.
Did they actually use those words?
What?
Do you know that they actually used those words?
I don't know. They could tell her that this is... the drugs you are taking are for the whole of your life.
Yeah.
Not that means that she could take the medicine till she dies. So she was like a captive. She was like in jail because she had to take the medicine until she dies. So we felt bad also because our sister could take medicine today, tomorrow, the other day. And those medicine, she got side effects. Because of the medicine she was given.
This is the second sister. Now, what was the name of the first sister?
The name of the first sister was Teresa Najemba.
And the name of the second one?
The other one was called Najemba also, because it's a family name. She was Ruth Najemba.
Okay. And what were their ages?
The ages?
Yeah.
And the first sister was she was in 30s. The second one was in 20s.
Okay. And were they married?
No, they had, one of them had boyfriend. They had boyfriends, by the way.
Yeah.
But they were not married. They are not married in churches.
So what was the reason for them to go and be tested?
So the reason for them to go for testing is that they were not trusting themselves the way they were moving, because they were not they had different boyfriends.
Yeah.
And they could tell us on the radio, over the radio, that you have to go to for testing because you don't know your status. You have to know your status, the HIV status. So they went to hospitals to be checked.
And this was when, roughly?
The first sister died in 1997.
Yeah.
The second one died in 2003.
Okay.
Yeah.
So with regards to Teresa, did she have any health problems up to when she was tested?
The health problem she had, for us we could see her normal. She was like normal.
Yeah.
But ever since she went to the hospital, when they tested her positive, she lost all the courage. All she could think about was death. She could spend the money anyhow.
Yeah.
Yeah. Because she had worked for so long, but when she lost her courage, she lost the money.
Yeah.
She couldn't work. She could only buy medicine. she was thinking about death only. Yeah. And even she couldn't talk to us very well as she used to.
Yeah. And how many times did she test? Do you know?
The times she tested?
Yeah.
I'm not sure of the times she tested, but when she tested first, she went back home. She told us that she was positive. She went back home, she told us that she was positive.
Yeah.
And then we encouraged her that she could be well, even her heart, because they intimidated us. They told us that AIDS has no cure. So we all got scared in our hearts that our sister is going to die, our sister is going to die. Mm. All what we could see was death on our sister. No hope, nothing. And during that time, we didn't try to put our trust in God, because we had never preached to be, being preached to that God can heal or do anything. We lost all our courage.
Mm. Mm.
And no one could encourage her at home, since we could follow the doctor's words.
Yeah.
Mm. If a doctor could tell you that you are going to die, that you are going to swallow this medicine for all of your life, that means that there is no hope. Mm. Even the medicine you are going to swallow, they are going to kill you. You are going to die swallowing them. Because so that shows that even the medicine the people swallow cannot cure them.
Mm. Did Teresa take the ARVs?
Yes, she took them. She took them.
Was her health already bad before she began taking them?
No. After being tested HIV positive, anyway, they told her that she was having the virus. She was HIV positive. And then she lost the courage, so she started showing some signs that she was positive, growing thin, thinking all the time. She got skin rashes. She could go to hospital every time going to hospital. So they told her to start swallowing ARVs. She started swallowing them until she died.
Did her health deteriorate significantly after she began taking the ARVs, or did it improve?
Not really.
Which? It didn't deteriorate or improve?
No.
It remained
just like that.
And then, if I might ask, what duration of time was it between testing positive and death?
It was about 3 years, like 3 years. Oh, she died in 2003.
Yeah.
And for me, it was very young, and they told me, I was young. They told me that she tested in 2000, around 2000, she was tested positive.
Mm.
And in 2003, she died. So that duration of time, it is 3 years.
Yeah.
Actually, 3 years, yeah.
And what was the relationship between her and the relatives at home like during that time?
The relatives who did what?
What was the relationship like between her and her relatives she was living with?
The relationship? No, after being told that, after being tested HIV positive, she couldn't talk to anyone in a good way. She could see everyone. She could say that I love even the life of an insect, because for it is going to live more and more years than me. She could look at the birds in the air. She couldn't talk to us very well. She could chase the children away. She didn't like anyone. Apart from when she needed something from someone. That's when she could talk to someone. But when she couldn't get time for relaxing, you could find her crying sometimes.
Yeah.
Mm. Instead of relaxing like on Sundays, she could just cry sometimes.
Mm. Mm. Was she at any time during that process, during that time, sick? Other than having normal flu, the occasional bouts of malaria.
Okay.
Was she otherwise sick?
Yeah. Every evening she could tell us that she has fever. Every evening, she could tell us that she has fever, and she had the skin rash.
Mm.
Mm.
And was she living healthily?
Before testing.
I mean, you say that she lived this lifestyle. So do you think she was getting sufficient sleep, eating properly, drinking enough fluids?
No. She could, she ate as she used to eat. Eating meat, drinking
alcohol, yeah. Not water.
And afterwards, she left alcohol.
Yeah.
She couldn't drink anymore. But at first, she could drink sometimes.
Mm.
Yeah. But when they discovered she was sick, she continued eating as she could.
Yeah.
We didn't know anything about the natural diet.
Mm.
No, we didn't change the diet because the doctors didn't teach us to change the diet.
Mm.
They could keep... Should I continue?
Yeah.
They could keep her all telling us that give her juices, what to drink, for us we could buy sodas.
Mm.
Mm. We didn't know that there's any side effects in fats. We could bring chicken, what, meat to her.
Yeah, that's what she wanted.
Mm, that's what she wanted.
Yeah.
She didn't change that.
No. Mm. And was Ruth's story any different?
Ruth's story. For she was different somehow. Because for her, she didn't... for her, she tested when she was bad off. Yeah. She tested when she was about to die.
Mm.
Because... For he, she was hiding. She was hiding. She didn't want anyone to know that she's sick. So she was hiding. She came home when she was bad off because she disappeared for a certain period of time.
Yeah.
And when she came back home, she was bad off, totally bad off. They took her to the hospital. She was tested positive and she didn't come out of the hospital.
Mm.
Yeah. She was bad off. Actually.
And what, looking back, what do you consider was the cause of her illnesses?
I think she was even in a bad environment. Because we could see her children. No, her child. She had a child. Her child was in a bad condition. The signs of the child were showing that she was eating badly.
Mm.
And she was not in a good place. Not even Ruth, but I even lost my uncle in 2005.
Yeah.
Died of AIDS. He also disappeared. For him, he tested positive, and he didn't. We saw him once. When he came to us, he was not like an uncle to us, because he could keep on abusing us.
Mm.
And then he disappeared. We didn't know where our uncle had gone, until when they told that he's at the hospital. We went and saw him. Seeing him, he was very thin.
Mm.
He had been given the medicine, the drugs, ARVs.
Yeah.
He'd swallow them day and night. He could swallow medicine, just medicine.
Mm.
Oh, we got very scared. And after seeing him for about a month, he died. Mm. He was in the hospital, he was admitted. He was being given medicine. He didn't change his diet also.
Mm.
And he lost all his body. He became very thin. He had TB. He had diarrhea.
Mm.
And all the time he had malaria, he had TB. All the time he could tell us that he's feeling fever.
Yeah.
Mm. For him, he didn't have skin rash. No skin rash. And he's dying. He was in the hospital. So when they saw that he was very, very thin, they saw that they couldn't treat him anymore. They told my other uncles that take your brother back home.
Mm.
We have no more medicine for him. Just take him back home. Because when he dies in the hospital, you spend more money.
Mm.
So just take him back home so that he dies. So he died from home. And he died of AIDS because they tested him HIV positive. And when we could give him meat, she could give him everything he wanted. But I think what made him growing very thin is because he didn't have appetite. He wasn't eating like he used to eat.
Yeah.
Couldn't eat.
And did he have any illnesses prior to being told he was HIV positive?
Not really. For me, when I saw him, he was healthy. At first, he was very healthy. And when he came to our home one time, he came to visit us. He calls my mother. His sister was his sister. My mother is his sister. So he used to come to visit the sister. So he used to come very, very, very proud. He could bring her sweets, what, cookies, what.
Yeah.
This time when he came, after being tested, he was so annoyed. He called, didn't want even to talk to anyone.
How did he suppose he was infected?
Okay. For him, they told us, not him himself, but someone else told us that he had a second wife, though he was married. But he had a second wife somewhere, and that wife was not another. He had another woman, and that woman was not trustworthy.
Right.
Because that woman was not married.
Yeah.
And I think that woman could have infected my uncle. I don't know, but
did anybody investigate to see if this woman actually existed, and or to see if what the relationship was?
We didn't investigate to see the woman, and we've never seen him. We've never seen her. But the wife of that uncle who died is still there. She's still there.
And
she's still doing her work.
Yeah.
And she's praying to God.
Has she been encouraged to go for testing as well?
She doesn't want. She said that when she gets the results, she'll be like our uncle. She doesn't want to go for a test.
Yeah. How long is it since he died?
My uncle died in 2005.
Yeah.
And now they are 4 years since he died.
Yeah.
They're 4 years, because this is 2009.
Yeah. So now, both your sisters and your uncle had gone through similar experiences of testing positive and succumbing to taking AIDS medications.
They all changed their attitude. Apart from Ruth, for her she was bad off. She was tested when she was bad off.
Yeah. And what were her symptoms?
The symptoms? Very thin, sores in the mouth, and the stomach, though she was thin, but the stomach was somehow big.
Yeah.
She was very thin, sores, and she had even some wounds on the legs.
And how do you account for that now? Now that you're wiser, you're more knowledgeable about immune deficiencies, how would you account for her physical demise?
About Ruth?
Yeah.
Ruth, for me, what I know, that she couldn't, she was in a bad conditions where she was. She didn't tell us where she was living. But her signs and the things which she had, she came with to home, back home, show that she was in a very bad place. The place, like some African places where you find people are very, very poor.
And that's all together.
And the child's behavior show that where they were, it was a very bad place.
You're familiar with the AIDS treatment programs in Uganda and the promotions for life-saving drugs. Do you find any evidence in your experience that that these drugs are actually life-saving or improving?
Not really. Because if it was so, my uncle, when he started taking ARVs, because he got news that he was sick, and he told us that he was taking swallowing medicine. So, the more he swallowed the medicine, the more he got some other complications on the body, and the more he got discouraged, he himself. He didn't have any hope in the medicine, because they kept on telling him that he had to take the medicine till he dies. I don't think that the medicine is necessary. I don't think that medicine is useful, because even if someone swallows it, I don't see any change. Apart from they say, now I have another sister. I'm sorry to say that. Anyway, it has been in our family that I have another sister who's tested positive again. For her, she's still living. She prays to God. We encourage her, and now we try to change her diet. Though she was used to the Western diet, we encourage her that she have to take this and this. You have to eat this and this. And her husband died in 1993. She's called Maria. She's still living.
Yeah.
But at first she had not changed her diet. She was looking bad. She could take ARVs. She could look for survival. She was in a very bad condition. But one time she stopped taking the ARVs.
Yeah.
She stopped taking ARVs, but she's still living. She changed diet.
Are you quite sure she stopped?
She was told. Yeah, I know she was told, because I also read books. And whatever I learn from my doctors, the naturopathic doctors, I tell her that you have to eat this, you have to leave meat, you have to leave this, you have to eat fat.
Are you absolutely sure that she stopped taking ARVs?
Yes.
And this was when?
She stopped taking ARVs, and now it's like 2 years.
Okay. You said her husband died in 1993.
Yeah.
What was his diagnosis?
He was tested positive, HIV positive.
And did he take ARVs?
For the husband, I'm not sure whether he took. But for my sister, I know she used to take ARVs.
From around the same time that he died?
I think she started taking ARVs in, it's like 1999, 2000 some, I don't remember the year. But she used to take ARVs.
Following his diagnosis, was she also prompted to go for a test?
Yep.
And she was told she was positive?
She was positive.
There's one more question.
Okay.
Do you find any evidence in the idea that testing saves lives?
Testing, it is somehow confusing, but testing, when a person has been tested, what I've seen, after being told that he's HIV positive, that person looks at the grave, only the grave, all the courage goes, all the happiness goes.
Yeah.